after a 3-1 Spectrum victory on Sunday, the Flyers went west to the Igloo in Pittsburgh to finish the season series with the Penguins. Chico Resch getting the nod in goal, and although the Flyers would run up a 3-0 lead on goals by Tim Kerr, Mark Howe, and Murray Craven, the Penguins, sensing their last hopes for a playoff berth slipping away, managed to come from behind and gain a 3-all tie. They are a mere shadow of the team that battled the Flyers for the Wales Championship 2 years ago. And like the Penguins, they are battling to hold on to a playoff spot in the Adams Division. Le Petit Tigre, Michel Bergeron, currently the oldest active coach in the National Hockey League, has had an injury-riddled season similar to Philadelphia. They lost the first match of the year at the Spectrum on October 6-3 and tied last Saturday at Le Colisée at 2. Always an exciting matchup when they meet. It's the Flyers and the Quebec Nordiques coming up next. Prism Sports presents Philadelphia Flyers Hockey. Brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By your Delaware Valley GMC dealer, not just a truck anymore. By Texaco, super unleaded gasoline with Petrox detergent to help keep your car's power flowing. By Springfield Ford for those who want the best. By the Bell of Pennsylvania Yellow Pages, we wrote the book. And by your Subaru dealer, where customer satisfaction always comes first.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Spectrum for tonight's game with the Quebec Nordiques. I'm Bobby Taylor, and with me is the Flyers coach, Mike Keenan. Mike, over the past couple of months, you've had a tough time filling out the lineup because of so many injuries. Now with Dobbin, Knockbauer, and Berube coming up and playing so well, you get a little more flexibility.
We do, and when we have more players returning, that'll increase the flexibility, Bob. I think it's a good positive shot in the arm for the hockey club to be able to see those three people come up from Hershey to make a contribution. It sparks our club a little bit and adds a lot of depth for playoff competition.
Craig Berube quickly became a fan favorite in his first game here.
He established himself and declared himself the National Hockey League in game one, and I think in game, in shift number one, rather, and that's a good sign. He's a hard-nosed kid, wants to learn, and he really made big strides and improvement over two games. His first game was a little bit undisciplined, second game played intelligently with discipline and still hard-nosed.
Lineup changes tonight. I know Tockett's ready to come back in.
Yes, he is. Rick will be back in the lineup, possibly Scott Mellenby, and I'm not sure about the status now of other players. Dave Brown, as you know, was suspended today, and we're going to have to look at a couple of players and see how they are this evening. We skated a couple this morning, and if their injuries flare up, then we'll have to be cautious in the way we use them. If they're okay, then we'll have some choices to make.
Tonight's game with the Nordiques, a tough one in Quebec. It was a hard-fought 2-2 victory. Do you expect the same type tonight?
We do, because we're playing a team that has their backs against the wall, a team vying for playoff competition, and it's important for them, as every game goes by, that they try to chip away at each point. And for us, of course, we have those two objectives I just mentioned, first place overall and a strong finish going into playoff competition.
Well, good luck tonight, Coach.
Thanks very much, Bob.
Mike Keenan, now with their views on tonight's game, let's go down to Ed Van Impe and Gene Hart.
Well, Mr. Van Impe, a lot of youngsters in the lineup. You've seen Dobbin before, but you hadn't seen Berube till this time around. Give me an evaluation.
Well, I think Ginny's made his impression in the National Hockey League in the first two or three games. He's really established himself. We knew in Hershey, in the American League, that he's a hard-nosed kid. Well, it didn't take him long to come up and join the Flyers and prove it here in Philadelphia. And I think that, his play is speaks for itself. As Bobby mentioned, and he was talking to Mike, he's +3. He's a good, young, aggressive, hard-nosed winger.
And I'm sure, since you're out there in Saskatchewan, that you've heard of Callahoo, Alberta before.
To be very honest with you, no. I don't think too many people have, but I think they will in the future.
We've often heard, and particularly during your era, about the system, and nobody was able to define it. But I think you see a good definition here, Eddie, as players keep coming in from Hershey, and there doesn't seem to be a loss of continuity, perhaps in quality, but the team seems to function quite well.
Well, I think what happens there, Gene, is down in Hershey, John Paddock is using the same system the Flyers use. You really believe in good aggressive forechecking, and they're doing that down in Hershey. So as a result, when they come up and join the Flyers, whether it's midway through the season, towards the end of the season, whether it's for one game or five five or six games. They're used to that style of play. The Flyers play a good aggressive forechecking style. Here, we've been used to that for years, so they just step right in, pick up the tempo. The momentum just keeps right on rolling.
And with the centermen out at one point, Eklund, Sutter, and Zezel, the Flyers revert to the thing they do so well, defense. And they shut down Pittsburgh on Sunday and on Tuesday, except for that brief spurt. And, of course, held Quebec at home in a clutch situation to two.
I couldn't agree more, Gene. I think the Flyers in the past, you always win Stanley Cups or win, you know, league awards on good, strong defense. The Flyers have always had that for the last 10, 15 years, and they've improved it. And, again, it's so important to have good, strong defense with good goaltending going into the playoffs.